Hello, welcome to GeeklyEDU Math. In this video, we discuss the rules, or otherwise also known as the laws of logarithms, and we want to see how we can apply these in problem solving. So let's take a look at a couple of those laws. We just have a few there on the whiteboard. So we see the first law or the rule has got to do with the log of a product. Log the product of AB to the base x. How do we write that out? Well, that just simply becomes log of A base x plus log of B base x. So a product becomes the addition. The next rule there, we have log of a quotient, or log A over B base x. How do we rewrite that out? So that's going to be log A base x minus, in this case, log B base x. Next, we have a log of a power. So what we want to do here is that we want to take this exponent b and put it before the log, or go and multiply this exponent b with the coefficient of log. So that becomes b log a base x. The rule that we have there is log number x base x. So that just gives us a 1. So in other words, if we have a log of which the number and the base is exactly the same, our result there is 1. So let's take a look at some, perhaps two problems in which we exercise these rules we've just considered here. So the first problem I'm going to put up goes something like this. So we have the log of 16 multiplied by x base 2. So how do we expand this using our rules we just took a look at? So this is just equal to log base 2 of 16, what? And then we're going to add log x base 2. So we've split the multiplication of 16 and x. Well, what does this give us? So we now have the log. We want to write the 16 as a 2 to the power of something in its prime factored form. So this is going to be 2 to the power of 4 base 2 add log x 2. Now, what we learned is that this 4 is going to go all the way this side. So this is going to be a 4 log 2, 2, add log x2. Now, once again, one of the rules told us that if we have the log of the number and the base is exactly the same, what does that give us? Well, that just gives us a 1. So this then just gives us 4 multiplied by 1, add log x base 2. Well, this will just simplify to 4 plus log x2. Okay. So that problem was quite easy enough. We're going to take a look at another problem now, which we exercise once again those log laws we just took a look at. So another problem we have here is we have the log of number 3, or rather we're going to have the log of x over 27 to base 3. Right. So we have a quotient. What are we going to do? Well, we're going to get log of x base 3. We're going to minus the log of 27 base 3. So log x base 3 stays unchanged. Minus, we're going to want to break up the 27 into a 3 to the power of something. So 27 is 3 to the power of 2. Well, what are we going to do with the 2? We're going to bring it over to the front of the log there. So here we're going to be having log x base 3 minus 2 log number 3 base 3. And of course, we know that log of 3 base 3, that just gives us a 1. So we're going to have log x3 minus 2 multiplied by 1. That will just give you a 2. Okay, so quite interesting problems we just took a look at now. Basically, what were we doing? We were discussing those laws we took a look at. A product, a quotient, a power, as well as if we have the number as well as the base being exactly the same. Now, let's take a look at further laws of logarithms. So, I've got my laws here, or my rules. The first rule we want to take a look at, and sometimes we refer to some of these rules as the change of base rules. So log number BA, how can we rewrite that out? One way is to say that would be log B, let's say your base is X, over or divided by log A, and that would be base X. Another way of rewriting this out, another rule, is if you were to say this would be 1 over log, and then you just switch your number and your base around. So now it would be A base B. If we have the log of a number B and we have a fraction of 1 over a certain value, what we can easily do then there is we can say this is a different sign. So in this case, since this was a positive, it becomes a negative. Log, now you don't have the fraction B base A. And lastly, what we want to take a look at here is that if we have a power, a to the power of log, so my exponent is a log BA, well, what's very interesting here is that my answer is just simply going to be this B over here. So that is my solution. My answer is B. So in other words, a to the power of log BA is the base, so my answer is just B. Right, so let's take a look at some interesting problems which we can solve here with these rules together with the rules we just considered a little bit earlier on in our video just now. So we have the first problem we'd like to take a look at is log of 32 to base a half. Well, what did we learn? This changes sign. And we're going to have a log of 32. Now, this 2 will become a 2. Right. So now we're going to have negative log 32. We might write it in its prime factorization. So that will give us a 2 to the power of 5 base 2. Well, what happens to this 5? We learned in one of our laws, the 5 goes in front. So we're going to have negative 5 log number 2 base 2, and we know that log of 2 base 2 just gives us a 1. So in other words, our final answer here is negative 5. All right, let's take a look at another interesting problem. Also, we have here is we have the log of 3 base 81. Well, a rule we learned is that we can write this as 1 over log. We're going to switch this around. So we're going to have number 81. Our base is 3 now. And this becomes then easier to solve. So now we have log of 81. We can write as 3 to the power of 4. And we had a base 3 here. And of course, what do you see is that this 4, you can bring it in front. So this is going to give us 1 over 4. Log 3, 3, you know by now that log 3, 3 is just a 1, and of course this then just simplifies to 1 over 4, a quarter. And the last problem we just want to take a look at, we're just going to put it on the side there, is say for instance you have something as 4 to the power of log number 61 and 4. We learned that if we have such a case, well, our answer is just the number there represented there. So this just plainly simplifies to 61. That would be our answer. Okay, so I'm sure you enjoyed this video looking at these log laws or rules. That's it for now. I do encourage you to subscribe to GeeklyEDU to watch more logarithmic videos and certainly many more other videos of other topics which you might be interested in. Thank you.